For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Palace Hotel Bar Activity from your Sample Files folder. This worksheet records the headcount in the Palace Hotel Bar at different times of the day. Management have informed bar staff to record the headcount every hour. They'll then be able to allocate suitable resources so that they have enough staff at busy times. You can see that the bar stays quite quiet in the morning and then gets a little busier over the lunchtime period. It then stays relatively quiet until early evening and becomes busiest from 10 o'clock onwards. And you can see that the bar is very busy indeed between midnight and 1 o'clock in the morning. This is quite a wide worksheet, so Excel will print it across several pages. Let's see how Excel decides upon the page order. So I'll click the Page Break Preview button at the bottom right of the screen to enter Page Break Preview View. And you can see that Excel will first print page 1, then move down to page 2, then over to page 3, down to page 4, then over to page 5, and down to page 6. In Excel terminology, this is a down, then over printing order. But we'd like to print in a different way. Because for this report, a down, then over printing order doesn't work very well. We'd like to print this page first, then move over to this page, then over to this page, then down to this page, then over to this page, and then over to this page. In Excel terminology, this is an over then down page order. Let's now change the page order from down then over to over then down. To do that, I click the Page Layout tab on the ribbon, and in the Page Setup group, I'm going to click the Dialog Launcher button. That's the little button in the bottom right-hand corner of the Page Setup group. When I click, the Page Setup dialog is displayed, and I click the Sheet tab. Notice that the Sheet tab has a Page Order option, and the orders are down then over or over then down. And the little icon to the right of the page order now seems quite intuitive. I'm going to change from down then over to over then down. And when I click OK, you can see that I have the page order I want. First of all, page 1 is printed. Then I move over to page 2, then over to page 3, then down to page 4, over to page 5, and over to page 6. And for this report, that's a far more logical printing order. Now let's look at a completely different requirement. That is the requirement to print several worksheets at the same time. At the moment, I'm only printing the July and August headcounts. But I want to print July and August headcounts along with November and December headcounts. But I have no interest in September and October headcounts. To do this, I'll click the July-August tab, hold down the Control key on the keyboard, and then click the November-December worksheet tab. I should now be able to print out headcounts for July-August and November and December. Let's see if this has worked. I'll click the File tab on the ribbon and then Print from the left-hand bar. Notice that when more than one worksheet is selected, in the settings, Excel chooses Print Active Sheets by default. This means that it will only print rows shown on the two active sheets, that is, the two sheets that we've just selected. Let's now look at the preview to confirm this has worked properly. I'll click on the Zoom to Page button so that we can see things a little more clearly. And you can see that on the first six pages, I'm showing sales for July and August. And on the last six pages, I'm showing sales for November and December. So things have worked exactly as I wanted them to. I'll now click the Back button to move back to Page Break Preview view. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Palace Hotel Bar Activity 1. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 712. Print several selected worksheets and change the page order.